You know, we talked about that just moments ago. You don't see it often, right? 10-run lead and you use your closer. But Jack, you know what that is?
That's one of those baseball.
That's baseball.
Chaotic.
Yeah, that's baseball. I've seen it happen before.
With
Hoffman? Or
start by Hoffman. Used his fastball pretty well. What did you think of him?
I thought overall, I thought Jeff pitched well. You know, I thought the fastball had life. He was throwing strikes. The curveball came into play. He and Ryan mixed in a couple changeups as well. So, and I even saw a couple sliders in there. So, again, I think it was a fastball curveball mix. With the occasional change, occasional slider. The fastball, had at times outstanding location. Curveball, the big, the bigger 12-6 break. He landed it. He was able to throw below the zone. And got underneath some swings. So, he threw the ball well. The fifth and sixth, Van Slyke got a fastball out over the plate and squared it up. And then, they got to him a little bit in the sixth. Obviously, we had to make a move. But, for five innings, it was really, really good.
Did you see a greater confidence in that fastball than maybe you saw in spring training?
Yeah, I he's working on a little bit of a new delivery out of the stretch. The windup is pretty much the same, but we talked so much in the spring about a starting pitcher's success is based on locating the fastball. So I still think that Jeff continues to to work on that, and I think that's going to be a big part of his development moving forward is the fastball command. But tonight he did a nice job.
Nolan's kind of been bumming about his performance, even though it's been good. Today is a huge game, and maybe it's the biggest hit as well in the game. What can you say about Nolan today?
Yeah, Nolan, I mean, what, you get three ribbies, two ribbies? What do you get, three ribbies?
Two.
You got three knocks, you got two doubles. Two doubles and a single, some ribbies. He had a good game. Cargo had a good game, a couple knocks, three ribbies. Ian got us on the board early with a big hit in the first with the double. So, there's a lot of guys who contributed. So, it was a good offensive game. Even though they out-hit us, I still, when you put up 10 runs, it's a good game.
What was the approach to Reed?
Make him get in the zone. We faced him before. There's no secrets. Our approach is such where, we're going to look for the ball out over the plate. We know that he changes speeds. We know that he throws a curveball. We know that he throws a slider. We know what he has. We got to make sure that we're swinging at strikes and taking balls. That's the approach.
What do you think happened
with
Lyles and then
over? Lyles came in, did his job. Then he threw up a zero in the seventh. I think when these things happen, usually it's the elevated pitch. If you go back, and I haven't looked at the video, which I will, if you look at the balls that were hit for base hits by the Dodgers, they were balls up out over the plate. They weren't located pitches. Whether fastballs or off-speed pitches, they were not located. That was the issue.
But tonight, Jeff seemed to be relying more on that two-seamer than maybe we've seen before.
Ed, I think that, again, he does a combination of the four-seam and the two-seam. I don't think it was prevalent heavy two-seam. I think it was a combination. Again, I'm not sure exactly how many what the ratio was to 2-4, but it was a good fastball. Lost a little velocity in the sixth, but again, he threw the ball great, man.
Ryan Hannigan catches another good game.
Yep.
Is there something about him that works well with some of the younger guys?
No, I think just the experience shows up in his game calling and how he handles the guys in between innings, and the steadiness and the. And the confidence that the guys have with him in pitch selection. There's not very many pitches that are shaken off during the course of the game. He's acclimated himself very quickly in a short period of time, which is great, which is expected for a veteran catcher, a guy with some confidence. So he's doing a great job.
No way do the hitters in the
league. Yeah, I think so. Trace, that's a good point. We talk so much about him not knowing our pitchers, but he knows the league. He's been around enough to, know a lot of these guys. But I just think his presence, in the clubhouse as he moves through the day, as guys see him and talk to him when we have our pre-game meeting with the pitching coaches and the pitcher, and Ryan, productive meeting based on his experience, what he can bring to that meeting on those guys that he's faced, and just, you know, some basic pitching principles that, you know, that I've come to learn from him that he believes in, that, you know, we're on the same page in a lot of things. So, you know, he's been a great addition. It was a great sign by us late in spring training. You never know how a season's going to play out. And, you know, he got here, you know, from Tony's situation. And, you know, we've benefited from having Ryan Hannigan, for sure.
Hey, buddy, we didn't find out about Hoffman's start until today, obviously. When did you tell him, and how much time did you get to prep to face the Dodgers?
Well, we knew that this could happen. You know, I don't know the exact timeline, Patrick, but, you know, he came as the 26th man on Tuesday for the doubleheader. He was active in the second game. We told him that there was a possibility that he could pitch Thursday. So, I mean, that was, 48 hours ago?
Did
so,
he
there you go. Yeah, he stayed. Yeah.
Anything else?
Maybe it's early to ask, but do you look at going with six guys for a bit?
No. No. That's not feasible now. So, to your question, no.